Grimsby is a place where it has always seemed to attract pioneering people, people with a spirit to change the future. My family came to Grimsby in about 1878, and that was my three times great-grandfather, Robert Ormsby. Robert put all of his family, who had eight children, they took them on the new trains and they brought them up into Great Grimsby. And obviously thousands of people came here for fishing. They could put the fish onto a train and that evening it could be being eaten in a London hotel. That was just magic.
There were thousands and thousands of fishermen, but the camaraderie was so good. Nobody would ever see you without a couple of pounds in your pocket. You know, and if you were out of a ship for whatever reason, you know, you could go in a pub and somebody would give you £2 or £3 or buy you a drink. And, you know, the camaraderie was really, really good. I first took this ship in 1975 and I was here till 1983, till it all packed up. Everything was geared to the fishing industry. And once the fishing industry sort of went into decline, that was it. Grimsby didn't exist. But if they got this ship ready, I would go back. Yeah, and I'd go back tomorrow.
Grimsby's legacy is a fantastic fishing heritage, but we've had to come out of that and think differently. And over the last 5, 6, 7 years, particularly working with companies in the private sector, with public agencies and with the government, we've set about creating a new vision for Grimsby and the Humber region. And a big part of that vision is around offshore wind and renewable energy. So I think green energy is part of our answer for the next 30 to 50 years, and it is sustainable.
I went to university in Newcastle and we had a lecture one day and it was about how offshore wind was growing and developing in the Newcastle area and how it was regenerating the town, which was another northern town that had gone through decline. It had a really similar story to Grimsby and it really sparked my interest. It was something that I really connected with in that lecture that day. And that's where I started to look into more careers in this sector and to see that there was a really great future for Grimsby and lots of careers to aspire to for a young person like me. My father works just across the way here on the port, so next to our building here is the fish market. That's somewhere that he has gone every day for most of his life. I remember having a conversation maybe 3, 4 years ago about how our family name wouldn't continue on the port because I was working in a different role and my sister wants to work in a different industry, so my dad would be the last remaining person to work on the port with the surname Little. So for me to get this role and tell him that I'll be working almost side by side on the port, he just laughed. He's like, after all this time, we're going to continue and you're going to be working the same place that I've worked all my life, both of us.
That's right. Yeah. I mean, I've been down there all these years and it's just how strange that my daughter is kind of following in my footsteps,
yes,
but in a different industry,
yeah,
within the town, and it's fabulous.
Yeah,
fabulous.
I never thought that I'd end up working down dock, as you said.
Coming across the train line, it's coming down to the dock, my God, yeah.
I know, after amazing. All the stories, yeah, that you've said every, yeah, night.
I followed in my father's footsteps, and then, yeah, you're following in your father's footsteps. That's amazing, yeah, really.
My future is here at Grimsby. It's where my heart is. It's where I'm going to buy a home. It's where the stories start, and I'm going to have many stories to tell in the future, and it's all centred around Grimsby and that feeling of home.
The I think I was always quite interested in going into the engineering side of it, so it seemed like a perfect opportunity when the applications came out.
Me, I was just interested in engineering and wind turbines was the route for me to go down. That's why I got into it.
I was very keen in Grimsby geography going to school. So it's nice to work with like-minded people in the industry that are interested in the same stuff.
Yeah, I think this year is just like the foundation for the rest of our apprenticeships, just laying the basics before we got onto the wind turbine so that we have a basic idea of what we need to do.
This is where the blades will attach. We've got three main blade points. When the turbines spin, we go through the gearbox, which changes quite a slow rotation into a faster rotation, which obviously generates more electricity.
This is used to like basically set up the wind turbine in the best position, so if the wind's coming more of an angle this way, the wind turbine will slightly change and then the wind will be hitting it a more effective way, so you'll be getting more electricity from it.
I'd definitely like to obviously make my way through the company, hopefully become some sort of manager one day, but no, definitely staying within Ørsted because, like you said, green energy isn't going to disappear anytime soon and it's a company that's going to stay around for a long time.
Are you worried about seasickness?
I'm not worried about it, but I will be seasick. I can put money on it, yeah, definitely.
I was seasick on my first time, and I've been okay ever since.
Everyone's there to look after you. You've got so many people, team leads, WT3s and 4s, that will make sure you're their priority when you're offshore.
I'm going to be pretty interested in like travelling around,
definitely.
Even for a few years, and it'll be good to know if there's opportunities in like Taiwan or Japan or America.
Yeah.
You know, you've got the opportunities out there to sort of go.
Mimicking what we've got like here in Grimsby, elsewhere in the world, is nice always to know that we're just like not making just an effect here, but elsewhere as well.
You'll walk up those steps there and you'll go into sort of like a reception bit where you'll get like your room key and a sign and everything.
What time do you get up in the morning?
I probably wake up about 5 o'clock in the morning. Lewis, you probably wake up a little bit later.
Yeah, I'm normally about half five, about quarter half six, five, yeah. Get a bit more of a line.
But it's really important in your first year to get your time management
sort of get into a routine as well. Obviously, you've done it for a solid week, so after the first couple of days, it just sort of comes natural to body clock.
It's really important that you make sure you get out of bed because if you don't, then
the boat doesn't wait.
The boat won't wait for you.
Sunrises.
Looking forward to the sunrise?
Yeah.
Well, you'll only get that in certain...
still looking forward to that though.
You'll only get that January time.
I think I miss it every morning.
Seeing that from like top of wind turbine.
Get some good Instagram photos.
Oh, definitely.
I started my career in the military. I served for 12 years in the Royal Navy. And I wanted to start a family. That was the main reason I left, to be honest. I didn't want to be that guy who was away for his son's first birthday or his daughter's first birthday. So I think a lot of people are attracted to the renewable industry. It's because of the structure that we have. We have a lot of structure in the military, and there's a lot of structure in this role. Day to day, we need to be work smart and we need to work efficient. There's so many things that need to go right and we need to get right on time. So operating and maintaining a wind farm is like a military operation. But I think the most attractive thing for me was the work-life balance. So I could be at home every night, see my family. And Ørsted's vision is let's create a world that runs entirely on green energy. And I'm really proud to be part of that. If I can make a small impact into that and it carries on for my children, then why would not want to do this job? Okay, it's a job that gives you money, but actually it's really important to me for what we do and what we're trying to achieve.
We've now got over 300 people that work from Grimsby, from our East Coast hub in Grimsby. You know, and only in four years ago, that was only 20 people. So the growth is really, really rapid. We've done some analysis and we can see that most of the people that work from our base live within an hour drive. So again, being part of the community, it's really important because our people live and work in the community. And if they're living in the local community and they're earning money in their roles in this industry, then of course they're spending that money in those in the local shops, local services, their leisure time, all these kind of things. So it's a whole broader kind of benefit of what the industry is bringing to the town.
The day we opened, there was me and three members of staff. That was all there was. We've now three different sites with, I think, 23 employees, so we've grown quite a bit. And that's a lot of that is directly due to the offshore wind industry. And the masses probably accounts for 50% of our catering now is the offshore industry. A lot of other people in business I speak to are all other catering companies as well. They're all doing work for all the offshore industry now. So there is definitely an impact there. There's more people about. There's more money coming into the area. There's more being built. And the change on Grimsby Docks itself is quite massive. It was a very dilapidated, broken down, all broken buildings. The roads were not in a great state. And I think since the wind energy companies have come along, a lot's happened on there as well. The infrastructure's changing, old buildings are being torn down, more things are being built. So, loads of changes.
10 years ago, it probably would not have been possible to do what we've done here and open a brewery in Grimsby. The economic climate in Grimsby was different. The offshore wind was only just getting going 10 years ago, so you weren't seeing the benefits of that. But since we've opened, we've seen a huge number of people making dedicated journeys to this building to come and have a drink. I think within the next 3 years, this square mile of Grimsby near the docks is going to be absolutely unrecognisable.
I really feel if it can happen in Grimsby, there is no reason why it can't happen anywhere, and that all communities can feel the benefits of having a new industry like offshore wind in their area. Grimsby is becoming well known now as a leader in this area of technology and expertise, and it probably would not have happened if we hadn't have seen offshore wind come to the area. So it is the place that people want to come, whether they're coming from London or whether they're coming from America. We've had quite a lot of interest from the States. This is where they want to come. This is where they want to see how transformational a change can be from one industry. There are lots and lots of communities, not just in this country, but around the world, that are suffering from this post-industrial town syndrome that internationalism has affected. But if Grimsby can adapt, then there is absolutely no reason why other communities around the country and around the world can't adapt and accept something new, something different, something that is very much in the 21st century that will help the whole of the country.
Kept telling everybody when it first came up, saying this is going to be big, this is going to be very big, get onto it, and nobody was really getting on board, so I did it myself. I desperately wanted to be a fisherman, like my father was a skipper and my brother was a skipper, but my mum and dad didn't want that. My brother said he'd hit me if I did go to sea, and he was bigger than I was. So I started down here as an errand boy, and that progressed on to I became a fish auctioneer when I was 18. And then when I was 30 years old, that was when I started my own company. That carried on very well, and then unfortunately there was a downturn in fishing when Iceland came out with a 50 mile limit and then a 200 mile limit. So that destroyed half of the fleet in Grimsby. And then all of a sudden in 2005, wind power came to Grimsby. They had no local knowledge, and everybody said, go and seek it. And that's when I formed Wind Power Support. And it was brilliant, because there I was at the age of 60, and every day I met somebody new, I learnt something new, I earned some money. It was absolutely brilliant, and I'm pleased to see that it's still carrying on. And we were quite helpful. You know, people kept saying to us, you're doing such a good job, you know, and they were saying, what management systems are you using? How do you do this? And the only thing that I did in wind power was what I did for fishing. It's not rocket science. Boats come in, they want fuel, they want food, they want to change crew, they want repairs, and they want to get back out there again, because a boat in dock is not any money. And the rest is history. We had 10 years of helping to develop the wind power business in Grimsby. Yeah, one advice, if wind power's coming to your town, grab it with both hands. You will be rewarded. It's a fascinating ride.